Bhagavan Baba in his own discourses, he used to say, if you are smoking and you are a teacher, how can you ask your students not to smoke? If you are drinking, how can you ask your children not to drink? Don't you feel guilty about it? The guilt consciousness is very, very, very important. I'll give you a wonderful example. You'll be surprised. One day, Bhagavan Baba gave an interview to all the professors from the university. We were all in his interview room. He was talking. There was a visiting professor. He was about 60 years or so from Mysore University, a Sanskrit professor, who was into the habit of taking snuff. He used to pump snuff into his nostrils quite often. He was sitting in one corner of the interview room. He took out his tin, snuff tin, and he was going on taking snuff, even in the presence of Bhagavan. He's from outside Mysore. He came here to teach some courses, that's all. Swami was watching. The interview came to an end, and Swami looked at this professor and said, Krishnamurti, this snuff, you know, it's not a good habit for various reasons. It causes ill health to you. On the other hand, your pant and shirt are very dirty right now. There is snuff all over. And when I look at your kerchief, I get frightened, Krishnamurti said. It was so dirty, stinking, and it's all full of snuff. He sneezed out everything into that kerchief and he was carrying it in his pocket. So he said, but Krishnamurti was not to relent. He said, Swami, I'm already 60, 65 years. By stopping this, what's it I'm going to gain? Let me go ahead with this. He said, do what you like, but as a professor, you are not supposed to do it because your students, a lot of them, they watch. If you do it, they also think that there's nothing wrong in doing it. You have a moral responsibility, better you be careful. Interview got over. Next day morning, we were sitting in the veranda. Swami sometimes finished interviews in the morning within half an hour. So on that day, and we used to gather about 10, 15 of us teachers used to wait for second darshan, additional darshan, one more darshan, before going to college. We were sitting there, Swami came out, and he used to talk every day to us. On various things he used to talk, excellent things. It's Brahmajnana. Whenever he spoke, it's Brahmajnana. Swami declared, I don't waste my words on people who don't care. Na matalu ratanala mootalu. All my words are like packs of diamonds, he said. Every word is like a diamond. This I give you to be utilized in your lives and correct yourselves and lead a very good life. So he was in front of us, talking to us, and in those days he used to take paan regularly. And he was having a kerchief. He was wiping his lips in between. He was talking and talking. Suddenly he looked at his kerchief. He looked at his kerchief, looked at us. Looked at the kerchief, looked at us. And suddenly he said, yesterday in the interview, didn't I ask Krishnamurti to stop taking snuff and criticized on his kerchief? Yes, Swami. Oh, look at my kerchief today. This also, there are stains on this. It looks very ugly. I think, it's a bad habit to take pawn. So I should stop it, he said. He was holding the kerchief like this. He dropped it and said, from now onwards, I will not take pawn. Dropped. Which he was taking for decades and decades and decades. Right education is not simply acquiring knowledge. What is the use of filling your minds with all kinds of knowledge from various books which you don't practice in your life? Swami always said, whatever I teach, I always practice in my life.